a plugin developer paid me. That's right, me, to test their transformer-based line amp plugin. And many of you will be asking,
Paul, why didn't you check this out when it came out last year?
Well, one, hated the GUI. Two, they kept on tweaking and updating it constantly. Which brings us to today, where I have version 3, and I have been told that it is the finished version, which is ready for me to compare against anything I so wish. That's how confident Pulsar Modular is in their product. Well, just for now anyway. But before we go into the audio comparisons, it's very important that you first understand what a line amp is in order to fairly compare and test against hardware and other plugins. A line amp requires a line level signal, which is the specified strength of an audio signal before amplification. Very important that you don't confuse this with a preamp, which you would use for a microphone, as a microphone outputs an extremely weak signal, which needs preamplified to a line level signal before it can be amplified further. Why is this so important to this video, you may be asking? The reason why it's so important is because we are dealing with units that use transformers to raise the voltage of the signal. Transformers in their nature produce harmonic distortion, and the behaviour and amount of harmonic distortion created is dependent on the type of transformer and also the amount of amplitude required to raise that voltage. So the harder you hit the line amp, the more saturated it will become. I read somewhere that a line level signal is something like 1,000 times stronger than a microphone signal. So just think of the amount of amplification required by the input transformer to raise the voltage of that signal to line level, and the amount of harmonic distortion that that can create, which is why a lot of modern clean interfaces and mic pre's like Audient are transformerless to limit the amount of harmonic distortion. So knowing that, you can understand why comparing the p42 plugin, which is emulating a very rare transformer used in famous line amps, to a mic pre doesn't make any sense, as there will be big differences in harmonics. And this is why I made the decision to incorporate Mix Analog's Neve 1084, as it is a line amp and can only be used for pass-through. And to make things even fairer, I bounced sweeps of the Neve 1084 at different input levels to better match the harmonics created via the plugin presets, which, as you can see, looks like Pulsar Modular's presets are of a Neve 1084 being hit pretty hard for more grip. Right, so now we've got all of that kind of boring stuff out of the way, let's hear how the P42 compares to a real Neve 1084 line amp on a kick drum. Okay, so pretty close. However, the P42 isn't the only plugin that does the Neve transformer thing, right? Acustica actually sampled Neve line amps, and the harmonic structure of the plugin matches that of the 1084. And for anybody questioning the aliasing, as you can see, it is all under the audible threshold. The P42 still does a very comparable job and still does add that like extra little bit of impact, but it doesn't sound as close to the hardware as Acustica. But still makes a positive impact nonetheless. Just listen to the bass examples here, and you'll hear, like in the kick, how they haven't managed to nail those low lows which give you that weighty Neve summing effect that you'd normally hear when using gear with transformers. As you can hear, the P42 seems more dialed in to emphasise the mids more with that high shelf, so the differences in the lows are more masked by the brighter overall tone. Again, I don't know if that's just because these Neve presets were tuned by ear, I can't really say for sure. But to give the P42 its due, it does advertise to give you the sound of many different devices from Neve, Wolfbox, DI, Studer, 812, and he was working on a Telefunken M15 tape preset the last time we spoke. However, these are all using the same saturation algorithm. Surely there are differing harmonic responses and dynamic differences that wouldn't make this possible. You would think, anyway. I can hear even more now how everything I stick it on, it lacks in that low weight department compared to what I'd expect a push transformer to give me. But the P42 has been getting a lot of noise with mastering engineers, apparently. Now, I'm not a mastering engineer, so I decided to simply compare a mix I finished with two P42 presets. One is a Neve 1080 mix preset, and the other is a Fusion preset where you need to use three instances in a certain order. I tried the mid-side presets in two instances, but it just sounded really weird to me, and I didn't like it. Just, I didn't see the point in using it. There are videos available from the developer going through the mid-side capabilities of the plugin, so I'd suggest you check that out if you are interested. Now, these tracks are level matched, so let's hear if they do improve my mix. Is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring me down. So I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring me down. So I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Mine is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring me down. So I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Mine is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring me down. So I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Is where I choose to reside, yeah. Saying all you ever tried to do was bring me down. So I turned around and then you shot me in the back. Overall, I think the P42 is a good sounding plugin that has that subtle enhancement that gives the track more punch and perceived loudness. It feels like 75% there, and this to me is the P42's biggest downfall. It's just too fucking expensive. Like, in reality, it's a £100 plugin that probably goes to like 50, 60 quid in a sale. It's not got the options to compete in that price bracket. It's not enough to say that it's got the hardware sound, and even with the new GUI, it's still not the most intuitive plugin to use. It is better, way better than what it was in version 1 and 2, and it's great that it's got oversampling, which to be honest is hardly needed unless you abuse the saturation, but it's good it's there. But really, when you put it into context of, like, say, the Arboreal Pimax that I reviewed recently, it's 20 quid and has a complex saturation algorithm, oversampling, linear phase and multiband options. 20 quid. That's 10 times less expensive, and it sounds awesome. If this was 5, 6, maybe 10 years ago, yeah, £200 probably would be a going price for the Pulsar P42. However, it's just my opinion, right? Let me know your thoughts down below as always. Right? Perhaps I'm being too harsh and expecting too much. Maybe I've missed a point altogether, right? It's possible, right? Demo it, try it out yourself, and don't be shy to let me know your opinions, because as always, audio is subjective, and my opinion is just one person's opinion at the end of the day. See you next week.